Welcome to Biologics. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about basics of sequence alignment. If you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe the channel for new educational content every week. Let us begin. Learning objectives. In this tutorial, we are going to learn about definition of sequence alignment, global alignment and local alignment, significance of sequence alignment, overview of methods of sequence alignment, pairwise sequence alignment and multiple sequence alignment, dot matrix sequence comparison, dynamic programming algorithm for sequence alignment, word or k-tuple method of sequence alignment. In biology, all of us share a basic question: what properties are shared among organisms? Comparative genomics and genome sequencing allows comparison of organisms at DNA and protein levels. Sequence alignment is a way of arranging the sequences of DNA, RNA or protein to identify regions of similarity that may be consequence of functional, structural or evolutionary relationship between the sequences. The sequence comparisons can be used to find evolutionary relationship between organisms, identify functionally conserved sequences, identifying corresponding genes in humans and model organisms to develop models of human diseases. Sequence alignment. Sequence alignment is an important first step towards structural and functional analysis of newly determined sequences to draw functional and evolutionary inference. The sequence alignment is made between a known sequence and unknown sequence, or between two unknown sequences. The known sequence is called reference sequence and the unknown sequence is called query sequence. The sequences are either aligned in group of two, which is called pairwise alignment, or more than two, known as multiple sequence alignments. Sequences are aligned by searching for series of individual characters or character patterns that are in the same order in the sequences. Identical or similar characters are placed in the same column, and non-identical characters can either be placed in the same column as a mismatch or opposite a gap in the other sequence. In an optimal alignment, non-identical characters and gaps are placed to bring as many identical or similar characters as possible into a vertical register. Depending upon the region of comparison, alignments are divided into two types of global and local alignment. Global alignment. Global alignment program is based on Needleman-Wunsch algorithm. In global alignment, two sequences to be aligned are assumed to be generally similar over their entire length. Alignment is carried out from beginning to end of both sequences to find the best possible alignment across the entire length between the two sequences. The two sequences are treated as potentially equivalent. Our goal is to identify conserved regions and differences between the two sequences. For example, if we check in this adjoining figure, we can see that the two protein sequences are aligned from beginning to end and the similarities are marked, while the differences are either aligned in the form of gaps and mismatches. Global sequence alignment is applied for either comparing two genes with same function or for comparing two sequences for conserved region among them. For example, here the three conserved residues between the two sequences are highlighted using the red box. Local alignment. Local alignment programs are based on Smith-Waterman algorithm. Local alignment does not assume that the two sequences in question have similarity over the entire length. Rather, it only finds local regions with the highest level of similarity between the two sequences and aligns this region without the regard for the alignment of the rest of the sequence regions. There are three primary methods of producing local alignments: dot matrix method, dynamic programming and word or k-tuple method. In local alignment, our goal is to see whether a string or a substring in one sequence aligns well with the substring in the other. Local alignment is applied for searching local similarities in large sequences or for searching conserved regions or domains or motifs. Significance of sequence alignment. Sequence alignment is useful for discovering functional, structural, and evolutionary information in biological sequences. It is important to obtain the best possible or optimal alignment to discover the information. Sequences that are very much alike or similar in the parlance of sequence analysis probably have the same function, or there may have been a common ancestor sequence, and thus the sequences are then defined as being homologous. The alignment indicates that the changes that could have occurred between the two homologous sequences during the course of evolution. For example, in this figure, we can see that the gene A undergoes gene duplication event, and later, after several generations, it forms a speciation event, creating two separate species, species 1 and species 2, as shown in the figure. Methods of sequence alignments. There are two methods of performing sequence alignment: pairwise alignment and multiple sequence alignment. Pairwise sequence alignment methods are used to find the best matching piecewise, means local or global, alignments of two query sequences. Pairwise alignments can only be used between two sequences at a time, but they are efficient to calculate. Pairwise alignment of two sequences is performed using methods such as dot matrix analysis, dynamic programming algorithm, word or k-tuple method. The word or k-tuple method is being used by programs such as FASTA and BLAST. Multiple sequence alignment, or MSA, is generally the alignment of three or more biological sequences of protein or nucleic acid, and the sequences are of similar length. From the output of the alignment, homology can be inferred and the evolutionary relationship between the sequences can be studied. MSA can be performed using methods such as dynamic programming approach, progressive method, and iterative method. Such methods are used by programs such as ClustalW and ClustalOmega. Dot matrix analysis. A dot matrix analysis is primarily a method for combining two sequences to look for possible alignment of characters between the sequences. It was first described by Gibbs and McClintyre in 1970. The method is also used for finding direct or inverted repeats in proteins and DNA sequences, and for predicting regions in RNA that are self-complementary and have the potential of forming secondary structures. A dot matrix analysis is a grid system where the similar nucleotides of two DNA sequences are represented as dots. Hence, it is also called a dot plot. Dot matrix is a pairwise sequence alignment made in the computer programs like Dotter and Dotlet using colorless dots. Let us assume we are combining two sequences A and B. In the dot matrix method of sequence comparison, sequence A is listed across the top of page and the other sequence B is listed down the left side, as shown in the figure. Starting with the first character in B, one then moves across the page, keeping the first row and placing a dot in any column where the character is A is the same. The second character in B is then compared to the entire A sequence, and a dot is placed accordingly. Whenever a match is occurred, this process is repeated and continued till the page is filled with dots representing all the possible matches of sequence A and B and the other characters between them. Any region of similarity between the two sequences is revealed by a diagonal row of dots. Isolated dots that do not fall on the diagonal row represent random matches that are probably not related to any significant alignment. Dynamic programming algorithm for sequence alignment. The dynamic programming algorithm was introduced by Richard Bellman in 1940. The word programming here denotes finding an acceptable plan of action, not computer programming. Dynamic programming is a problem-solving process where complex problems are broken down to simpler sub-problems, which can be further divided into many smaller parts. Dynamic programming is widely used in bioinformatics for the tasks such as sequence alignment, protein folding, RNA structure prediction, and protein DNA binding experiment. First dynamic programming algorithm for protein DNA binding were developed in the 1970s independently by Charles Delcey in USA and Georgi Gursky and Alexander Zasadetlev in USSR. Global alignment program is based on Needleman-Wunsch algorithm and local alignment on Smith-Waterman. Both algorithms are derived from the dynamic programming algorithm. There are three steps in dynamic programming: initialization, matrix filling or the scoring step, traceback step. It is the step from which the alignment can be constructed. Initialization step. The first step in the global alignment dynamic programming approach is to create a matrix with m plus 1 columns and n plus 1 rows, where M and N correspond to the size of the sequences that are to be aligned. Now, let us learn dynamic programming for global alignment using an example of two DNA sequences. Let the two sequences be, sequence 1 is of 11 nucleotides and sequence 2 is of 7 nucleotides. So, we are going to form a matrix of 12 columns and 8 rows as shown here. Now, let us begin the matrix filling step. Here, the first column and first row will be empty and the first block will be filled with 0. Score the matrix will follow a scoring pattern where a match will score plus 1 point, a mismatch will score minus 1 point and a gap will score minus 2 points. Then, the first row and first column will be filled with values equal to the multiples of gap penalty. It is done to assume if none of the bases align and they need to be adjusted using gaps, then what would be the score? So, we are filling the first row and first column with multiple of gap penalty. While filling the matrix, there are three possible values for a cell that can be derived. Let us assume that this is a cell and its values can be derived from the horizontal cell adjacent to our query cell. And in that case, the score will be obtained by adding the score of the adjacent cell with the gap penalty. Now, we can also derive the score of our cell from the vertical cell present above the query cell above it, that is from the vertical direction. And for that also, we will add the score of the previous cell with the gap penalty. And we can also obtain the score from the diagonal direction. In that case, the score will depend upon match or mismatch values of the two characters or nucleotides. We have to write the maximum possible score that can be obtained from the three combinations in the cell. So, this is our matrix and we have filled our first row and first column with the multiples of the gap penalty along our column and along our horizontal row. Now, let us focus on the first cell shown here. The score for this empty cell can be obtained from the adjacent cell and for that, we'll need to add the gap penalty to the score of the adjacent cell and that will be minus 4. Similarly, we can also obtain the score from the vertical direction, vertical cell. And for that, we'll also add the gap penalty to the value of the vertical cell. And that will also bring us minus 4. And we can also derive the sequence from the diagonal direction. And to do that, we'll have to check whether the two nucleotides are a match or a mismatch. Here we can see that the two nucleotides are a match because both of them represent the residue guanine. So, the match score is plus 1. Then, we'll add 0 to plus 1, which brings us to the value of 1. So, in this cell, we have written the highest possible value that can be obtained from the three combinations. We'll follow this scheme of action throughout the matrix and fill the whole matrix using this scheme to obtain the highest possible value. As you can see, we have already filled the matrix here using the similar technique and this brings us to the completion of the matrix filling step. After the matrix has been filled, we'll need to do backtracking step. The backtracking step determines the actual alignment that results in the maximum score. In backward tracking, we have to move from last cell, the lowermost corner, and follow with an arrow to the cell from which value for the current cell is obtained and we'll have to move along the same line. So, for our matrix, we'll start from the rightmost corner. Here we can see the value minus 3 could have been obtained only from the diagonal direction because if we add the gap penalty to 6 from the vertical direction, it will bring us to minus 8 and from the horizontal direction, it will give us minus 5. Since A and A are a match and if we derive the value from the diagonal direction, then we can have the value of minus 3. So, we'll mark it with an arrow. Now, the value of the cell minus 4 is derived from the cell adjacent to it. We'll mark that like this. Similarly, the value minus 2 is derived from its adjacent cell. And the cell shown here gets value of 0 from the cell above it. As you have seen, we have marked the cells from which the value of the current cell has been derived. And this has shown us an ideal and optimal path. Now, for clarity, we'll black out all the irrelevant boxes and only leave our optimal path. Now we have to align the two sequences and for aligning the sequences there are two rules. If the values come from diagonal column, we'll have to write two bases in alignment. If value of a cell comes from a horizontal cell or vertical cell, then we'll have to add a gap. The location of the gap in sequence depends on its position. If a cell derives its value from the adjacent cell, then a gap will be placed on the sequence present along the y-axis of the matrix. And if the value of the cell is derived from the vertical cell, then a gap is introduced on the sequence present along the x-axis. So, for our alignment, the two sequences when aligned using the dynamic programming algorithm, we can find that the two sequences result in 6 matches and 4 gaps. For performing local alignment, the algorithm is same as in global alignment, but there are some changes. Fill the first column and first row with 0, whereas in global alignment we fill them with the multiples of gap penalty. If the value comes in negative, then it is replaced by a 0. The score matrix for local alignment is like this. For a match, it scores plus 1 point. For a mismatch, it scores a minus 1 point. And for gap, there are no penalty. The reason for absence of penalty in local alignment is that when we are aligning particular few residues, then it does not get affected by the length of the sequence. So, we do not include any gap penalty for local alignment. Here also, the backtracking will start from the cell having the maximum value, the word orcatable method of sequence alignment. It is used to find optimal alignment solution, but is more than dynamic programming. The method is useful in large-scale database searches to find whether there is significant match available with the query sequence. Word method is used in the database search tools such as FASTA and BLAST families. This program searches and identifies a series of short non-overlapping sequences or words of the query sequence in the selected database. Hope you have enjoyed learning the basics of sequence alignment. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more educational content every week. Thank you and happy learning.